Hello everyone, I'm going to work on my Malagite inspired painting again, but first of all I want to thank some people, and I want to thank Dolores, Brenda and Adina Ruxandra for sponsoring me. So thank you so much, I can't tell you how grateful I am, and so if you watch this video, thank you so much for what you did. So I already placed some green crushed glass around, the small puddles, and now I'm pouring some clear resin on top of them to make sure that they are that they stay in place. So I am I've thought about this painting, and I already know that this is a hard time for me, but yeah, it's also a learning process, because some people in the comments, and I want to thank you also for that, commented that it's a learning process, and also for me, and I'm glad you all remind me of that, because something can go wrong, then you need to change it, but I'm happy what I have now, and I'm going to add some details to it. Around the puddles I'm pouring a glitter line, and that's the Hunter Green of the Cosmic Shimmer Glitter Bits. And I'm also making some smaller puddles, and I'm starting with that now. I also have added a new color that I didn't use before. I added the Cool Mint of Lures. It's a very nice color. It has no sparkle, but I like that, because all the other colors, almost all the other colors are very sparkly, except for the white I used. So I wanted to have a color that hadn't any sparkle in it. So that's why I chose the Cool Mint of Lures. So very little puddles I'm making in the center. So again, I'm dripping those colors onto each other, and I'm using only four colors, and that's the Cool Mint of Lures, the Emerald Green of Just Resin, the Snow White of Artisou, and also the Jade, and then the Powder of Artisou. So all the colors are listed in the beginning of this video, and also in the description box below this video. So if you want to see where I buy them, then you can check that out. And also I have divided it in the countries, so if you want to see what I buy in the USA, then I have divided that, so yeah, then you can check that out. So I speeded this video a little bit, because this is very time consuming, so yeah, and those puddles are laying a little bit on top. I like that, because then you get a little bit of structure in the painting. And also the crushed glass gives structure in the painting. So that's good. I like that. And now I want to define some areas a little bit more. Yeah, and the painting dried very well, so it looks very good. You can see I drip very small drops onto the puddle, so that the puddle stays small. And if it doesn't be round, I don't mind. I like that it gets another shape. Yeah, this takes a lot of time. Yeah, and I keep adding those small puddles until I think it's enough. Yes, and I also chose these colors because I want to challenge myself, and because I like to do that, not just stay in your comfort zone, but also yeah, pick the colors that you normally wouldn't choose. So yeah, also to learn to work with also these colors. So almost done with the petals. Again, I'm adding some clear on top of the crushed glass. Yeah, and I also like it that the white underneath the crushed glass is shining through, so that's good. Yeah, now I'm starting on some petals in the green, in the emerald green, because I think it needs something there. And they are going to be a little bit larger than I have in the center. And if they get another shape, I don't mind. They don't have to be perfectly round. And they can flow a little bit. So again, the same colors for these petals. And the same technique, dripping onto each other, the colors. And then the petals will get bigger. Yeah, I'm going to do more than one puddle because it's a large area of green. And then it gives also the painting a little bit more balance if I have something on the left side. So that's why I also make these puddles to balance the painting. But I stay in the green colors. All the other colors, the yellow I used and the gold, the pale gold, are all gone. And I like it better that way, that it's almost all the colors are cream except for the white. But that's good. So again, I'm dripping those colors onto each other. Another puddle, and the other two puddles are getting a little bit bigger, so that's okay. And you can already see that my resin is getting thicker, so my working time is almost over, and I have a working time of 30 to 45 minutes. It's also depending on how warm it is outside. But normally I have 30 to 45 minutes. Yeah, and it looks okay. Also in the left corner, some puddles. That's the nice cool mint of Lares. That's the emerald green of Just Resin. And the snow white of Artisou. And the jade, but then the powder. Also from Artisou. Very nice sparkly color. So now I'm adding some clear around the puddles because I want to have the puddles to get another shape. And that's why I'm pouring the clear around it so that it can flow into the clear. You know, with my stirring stick I take a little bit clear out of the cup and then I pour it around it. And you can already see that the puddles are not round anymore, so that I find that nicer. Another puddle in the left corner. And then I am going to stop because the resin is getting too thick. So then I let it dry for 24 hours and then I'm going to work on it again. And add more details. To create maybe some depth and also to define some areas a little bit more and to give it a little bit more structure. A little bit of clear around the puddles. And I'm going to let it dry for 24 hours and then I will work on it again. So it's 24 hours later and I already placed some glass glitter around the small puddles in the center. And it was very time consuming, so I didn't video it. But I glued it first with a diamond glaze on top of the resin. Because if I pour the resin on top of it, then the glass glitter will flow into the resin. And that's why I glued it first with some diamond glaze glue. And that's also a glue that I use for my jewelry. So, and that works because now the glass glitter is stuck onto the resin and it doesn't flow in the resin. So it stays a line. I like that. And I also added that glitter because I want to define those puddles a little bit more. And in the close-up video you will see this much better. But I like it. It's very nice. And now I'm adding some clear on top of the crushed glass. And at the moment I'm adding some glitter to give it more sparkle. But I've added some clear on top of the small puddles so that the glitter is underneath the resin. I like that. So on top of the crushed glass, some nice glitter in the jade color. Very sparkly. And again, I'm adding some clear on top of the puddles. And you also can see that the puddles on the left side have a whole nother shape. I like that. It gives a little bit of a flow in the painting. More clear on top of the puddles and also the area around the puddles. Yeah, and by adding those details, the painting, in my opinion, comes a little bit to life. So I like that. So I'm going to add more details. And yeah, I'm very pleased how it looks now. A nice glitter line around the puddles. Because also that area I want to define more. And that's a glitter in the color jade. And I also mix some Recollections glitter in it. And it's the sea green. So around the petals, some nice glitter lines. Yeah, with my stick I'm pushing the resin, the glitter where I want it. Also in the right corner, a glitter line. And also there I'm using my steering stick. Also the torch for the air bubbles. Now I'm pouring some clear around the puddles. A very thin line. Because I'm going to use some pearlized mica flakes on top of it. To give it more structure. I like that. Very nice flakes. Also these are where I buy them. Are in the description box. The link where I buy it. And with my steering stick I push the flakes into the clear and against the glitter line. Also the other puddle. And again with my steering stick I push the flakes into the clear. Yeah, it looks very nice. I'm happy. Yeah, sometimes I'm very hard on myself because I also have a part in me that's a very perfectionism. And sometimes that's in my way. Now some clear against the glitter line. A thin line, and also there are some pearlized mica flakes. To define that area also a little bit more. And again with my steering stick I push the flakes into the clear against the glitter line. Also in the right corner some clear, because there are also some mica flakes against the glitter line. And again with my steering stick I push it into the clear and against the glitter line. Yeah, and now again some clear on top of the small puddles in the center and also the area around it. Yes, and I'm so happy how it looks now. I'm very pleased. And I learned a lot during making this painting, and I learned that I need to trust on my feelings, and then it will all be okay, and not get frustrated, because you can change the parts you don't like. Also at the end of this video a close-up, then you can see the mica flakes up close and the crushed glass, all the glitter, the puddles and the glitter, the glass glitter around the small puddles. So if you want to see that, then you can wait until the end of this video. also the torch for the air bubbles, and after that we can go to the close-up. So this is how it looks now. I'm very happy because I like the mica flakes a lot, and also the crushed glass added some nicer texture to it. It sparkles a lot, and also the glass glitter around the small puddles. I'm very pleased about that. It defines that area a little bit more. So I learned a lot what I already said. Also some cells in the white. A little bit closer, then you can see the mica flakes up close and also the glitter lines, different colors. Very nice. There the crushed glass with the glitter on top to give it more sparkle. There the puddles. Looks good. There the very dark green glitter lines. There the other small puddles with the glass glitter around it that I glued with some diamond glaze. The nice emerald green of Just Resin. Yes, I'm happy how it looks now. And there are some cells also. Very sparkly. Yeah, and the next step is to remove the tape. And then I'm going to tape it again, but then just under the resin. And then I'm going to sand first the edges because they are sharp, and then I'm going to give it a clear coat. And I tape the sides because then my canvas stays clean, but it flows over the resin that I have on top of the canvas, so that I get a round edge. I like that more. And then it's all done. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. I would love that you do that. Also give me a thumbs up, that would help my channel a lot. And you can also find me on Facebook and Instagram. All the links you want to know are in the description box, also where I buy my materials. And I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!